Hey, what's up everyone, and once again, welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Last time, we made our way up this tower right here after exploring kind of this whole area. What tower even is this? The Ridgeland Tower. And in this episode, we're gonna actually activate the tower. But first, I want to talk to this guy. Hi. Branil. Ooh. You got an interesting face there, mister. It's quite high. If only I was a bird, man. Where did you come from? Don't scare me like that. I guess we are wearing Majora's Mask, huh? How did you get up here? Though I suppose you could ask me the same question. You see, I have dedicated my life to the study of birdmen. Their flight mechanics fascinate me. Given their weight, it should be physically impossible for them to fly with wings of their size. The bird, of course, flies anyway. I just don't get it. I was standing on the ground watching the skies when suddenly this tower erupted beneath my feet. I've been stuck up here since with no way to get down. But my misfortune is a blessing in disguise. You see, this tower is the perfect place to observe birdmen in their natural habitat. Oh my, now that you've climbed up here, how will you get down without falling? I suppose you're stuck here too. I'll just fly down. What? You can fly? You could fly like a birdman? Is that true? I thought it impossible for a Hylian to fly like a birdman. Oh, it's more like gliding then? That's still a step in the right direction. If I can analyze your glide distance and trajectory, it might help me understand the science of birdman flight. Then maybe one day I'll finally realize my dream of becoming a bird! Ah. Would you mind participating in a short research study? I want to see how far you can glide. You'll be compensated for your time and travel, depending on how far you fly, so how about it? Hold on, I need to activate this tower first. Before I came here, I met a girl who dreamed of touching the clouds. I want to make that dream a reality. Come back when you also want to achieve greatness. Okay, hang on, I just need to press the A button over here, my guy. Chill out.
Sheikah Tower activated. Regional map extracted.
Well, okay then. I don't know how Link sees out of this thing, but... Alright. I'm ready. I'm ready to achieve greatness or whatever. 20 rupee liability fee. Okay. Sure. So you're making me pay to do... Fine. Alright! Landing elevation, wind direction, stamina usage! Keep all of those in mind as you consider the farthest destination you can reach by gliding. If you're ready, let's take to the skies! Birdman research study, go! Hold on. I want to look up what this guy offers, because I feel like the further we go, the better stuff we're gonna get. So give me a second. Okay, so as expected, he offers better rewards the further you go, that's a given. But it's just rupees. We're not gonna get anything else from this guy, but I am gonna go ahead and do this. Just to see as far as we can go. You know, I am a little curious. I believe what I looked at, I think 600 was the best reward. Maybe we'll actually make it. Probably not though, because I don't think we have enough stamina. Maybe. We'll see. We're already a third of the way there. It's also a case of, like, as long as we don't touch the ground, you know, we might touch the ground before that. So far, so good. 300, halfway there. I think we're about halfway through our stamina wheel. Oh, no, actually, ooh. We might not have enough stamina. Do we have anything we can eat? Any stamina stuff? I don't think we do. We don't. Okay, it's just gonna be a case of going for it. I'd hope we don't touch the ground first. I hope we don't run out of stamina first. I just hope we do this. Alright, 100 meters left. We might have this. Come on, Link. 600 meters, that's all we gotta hit. Come on! Oh, just barely. 603. Whew! Alright, give me my reward, mister. Wherever you are you gonna load in? There we go. I guess we did go kind of far. Marvelous! What a breathtaking flight! I never dreamed a Hylian could fly 603.2 meters! Your methods may have been unconventional. I didn't see you flap your arms once, but they were effective. The field of Birdman research will benefit greatly from this data. You deserve heavy compensation for your stellar efforts. Please, take this! Silver rupee. So we made 80 rupees off of that. So, if you're still up for it, why not glide down again? The world of Birdman research waits for no man. Nah, I'm all done. Okay, but please come back soon. It's very boring up here. I bet it is. So that's the best reward we could get. I don't think he's gonna give us anything else, if we were to do that again. Alright, we've got that one pinned. We need to head for either blue or red. I would say blue is probably the easier one to get to. It's over that mountain. So I guess we'll go to that shrine first. We can kind of work our way around, if we head over to that shrine. Now, over there, that place is pretty cool. That place with the storm clouds. You know, big old storm clouds just hanging out over it, constant lightning. That place is pretty cool. I don't feel super confident in going over there at this current moment. Again, I want to get a certain ability from a certain champion before I really try and do any big stuff like that. The towers is the current thing, is our current goal. Get all of the towers, because obviously that can be done without said ability. However, a lot of stuff after that, I want to have that ability for, because it's just going to make things, it's going to make things a whole lot easier. You'll see what I'm talking about. I'm being very vague. But I promise you all will make sense. This guy's got a shield. Okay. Nope. Okay. Oh, that did big damage to us. Oh my god. Yeah, get down. Hit him with an arrow. Hit him with the thing. This is not going well. Oh, there we go. We staggered him for a second there. Spike Boca Club is going to break. Let's chuck it at him. There we go. You know what? Thunderstorm Rod, just for you. You can have this. Yeah, yeah, yeah! We're completely missing. We hit the guy in the back. Okay, this is not working at all. Ice Rod! Okay, and then break him! Yeah! I didn't even realize there was a guy further down. He was not happy about what just happened. Can I just bomb arrow you, actually? We have, an uncomfortably huge amount of bomb arrows. There we go. I don't know when we acquired all of these, but I'm not complaining. Oh, the Cobble Crusher's badly damaged. Okay. We have had this thing for a while, so that doesn't surprise me. You want this? Because you can't... Oh, where you at? Where you going? Where you headed? Boom! And then we have the Rusty Halberd. I'm not going to use the Rusty Halberd. If we see an Octorok... You remember that Octorok that we had to fight? Where it was, sucking things in and spitting them back out at us? I don't believe I mentioned this when we were fighting him, but... If you throw a rusty weapon at him and he inhales it, he actually fixes it. He makes it into a normal good weapon again. So I'm gonna hold on to the rusty halberd just in the off chance that we do see that, see another Octorok, because we can get it all nice and prettied up and actually use it. So that's exciting. Shrine nearby. I wonder where it could be. Can I maybe sneak strike this guy? Yeah. Oh, I picked the wrong weapon for it, though. That was a weak weapon. Oh, Dragonbone Boco Bat. Used by only the toughest Bokoblin warriors. This Boco Bat has been fortified by fossilized bone. It boasts a high durability and is strong enough to beat down powerful foes. Let's go ahead and put that on. We stole your weapon mid-fight and killed you with it. How do you feel? I guess you can't answer that question. You're dead. Alright, then. Very, very cool. There's, nothing else over here. Just the one Bokoblin. Actually, this part of the map... Mipha's Grace is now ready. Good. I was literally just about to point out how that hasn't recharged yet, so hell yeah. Hello, fox. Yeah, this part of the map just feels pretty barren. There's not a lot of enemies out here. Not a lot of anything, really, but I guess that's just what this region is like. Aha, there it is. Oh, hold up. Hold up. Let me break these open. Luminous Stone. Oh my god, the Luminous Stone guy. I keep forgetting about him. You guys aren't reminding me to go to the Luminous Stone guy. Monyatoma Shrine. Okay. Let me just take a look around here. Anything fancy? Anything cool? Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I think this is where we see Dinral. I think Dinral spawns in that, little chasm area. So maybe we can get the Dinral scale while we're here, actually. That sounds like a plan. Alright, let's do this. What shrine are we dealing with? I already see the end of it off to the side. Drawing parabolas. Okay. What? It's gonna show my my knowledge here. What's a parabola? I don't know. Nope, there you go. Whoa, there it goes. Was that right? I guess that was right. Now we get to go as well, Link. Let's fly. Maybe. Whee! Okay, not bad. Ball is here. Okay, the ball's just gonna keep getting sent back and forth. Okay, what is... I fell down. What does that do? Oh. Right. And now the... Oh. Alright, I see. I see what we gotta do. I think I see what we gotta do. We're gonna find out if I actually... I'm thinking this through correctly, because we got a chest up there we gotta get to. So, I guess I'll focus that first. I'll focus getting the chest, and then I'll focus on the ball. Come on, Link. Get down there. Is it... Are we stuck? Okay, there we go. Look at this dude! He's just wearing the Majora's Mask this entire time. I guess I forgot we had that on, because those Bokoblins actually weren't aggroing us, but... So that makes sense. Oh, I messed up again. Okay, hit that. Because that rotates it a little bit further, and then I think that's what we were supposed to do to get that chest. We were supposed to have it facing that way. That would make sense. That is just some boxes, but I guess we gotta break them. Boom, and boom, okay. So that's what we're getting the ball to. This doesn't seem too bad. But you never know. Okay. We're not gonna launch ourselves, but I'm gonna try and jump off of this. I'm gonna go like this, and then I'm gonna go, hook. Nope. I don't know why I thought that would work. Oh. Okay, Link. Link, buddy, get out of there. Alright, try that again. Try that one more time. I guess we can take the ball... Oh no, we can't really take the ball over to the next bit. That wouldn't work. This doesn't seem too bad. I think we've figured out the solution. It's just a case of actually executing it. Okay, launch me. Cool. Chest. Acquired. Now, if that's the only chest... Ooh, my god, a Thunderblade! Okay. A magical sword forged and refined by lightning from Hyrule Hills. When the blade shines with a golden light, it will electrocute enemies struck by it. That's a damn good sword right there. And that was the only chest. Okay, so I believe we just do that. And then that is the solution. We just have to send the ball over. Seems simple enough. It's just a waiting game at this point. Excuse me. There we go. Put that down. Send ourselves over with it. Let's go, ball! Okay, get in there. Get in there. Get in there. Oh, just barely. I should have jumped in there with it, but whatever. And then... Yep, that's the solution. Okay. Was it? Did it go in? It went in. And, okay, so that opens the door, but now that I'm thinking about it... Did we even have to open the door? Did it also open this door? Okay, good. It did also open that door. I was gonna say, otherwise we can just jump over there to the solution. Or to the end of the shrine. Good, I wasn't entirely dumb. Entirely. You know? Anyway, shrine complete. You've done a good job. You got your spirit orb. How many do we have now? 14. Two more, and I will make the trek back to Kakariko to level up. Okie dokie. And it's raining now. Okay. Oh, stable. Oh, we're gonna head down there. Hold on. Yeah, that's actually in the direction we're going as well, so that's perfect. I don't know how I didn't see that stable before, but we take those. And if I was correct before, I think this is where Dinral spawns. Wait. Yeah, there's like a chasm right here. I'm pretty certain this is where Dinral spawns. But let's head over to the stable first. Got an Armoranth right there. There we go. What are these? Endura Shrooms, I'll take them. Definitely take those. Everybody's probably inside. The Seren stable? Doggo doesn't care. We're gonna feed Doggo. Doggo does not care that it's raining right now. Here you go, buddy. We'll just hold three of them right off the bat. I think if we just give them all at once, he will eat them all. Look at him go. That's one. He's happy with that. Oh. What are you doing? Buddy, eat the meat. It's right there. Come on. There you go. And then the one that's right in front of me that Link's just staring at. You gonna eat that one? There you go. Is that enough? You happy with that? No, you want more? Okay. Well, I'm gonna do them one at a time now, because I want to make sure that you don't steal all of the meat that I have in here. Come on, buddy. Eat it. Eat that raw meat that definitely won't make you sick. Is that good? That's good. Alright, where are you taking me? The chest should have spawned now. Oh, it's right there. Yeah, I don't believe that was there before. Also, there's another dog. Do you also give me something? You also take me to a chest? Oh my god, a gold rupee! Okay, 300 rupees. It's radiant golden shine. I keep saying shrine. Illuminates your soul. Neat. What about you, little buddy? Do you also want this? I'll give you some meat. You can have some. Yeah. Hey, don't you take it. This is for the other dog. Don't you dare. If you go for it, I'm picking it all back up. There you go. I'm just gonna keep watching this dog. He's just staring right at us. No, 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 no. It's not for you. They're following us. Ah! We gotta do them one at a time then, so that only one dog gets them. You've already had 4 pieces of raw prime meat. You don't need any more. You already showed me where the chest was. We're trying to see if this dog knows where a chest is. Are you sneezing? They programmed the dog sneezing into the game. I love that. Don't you dare. There you go, buddy. I feel like maybe it's one dog per stable and I'm just wasting all this meat on this little dog, but... Yeah, okay. Well, we just fed a random dog. What up, dude? What a tranquil landscape. It's nice to relax and paint in a place like this every now and then. Hey, we meet again! Are you out traveling as well? I've traveled all over the world, so I'm happy to tell you about new places. Yep, I've got a picture for you. Check out my album. Where is that? Oh, I know where that is. It's north of the castle. Oh, that's north of the castle. Maybe I don't know where that is. Okay. The south side of the castle is where Castletown used to be, but I don't see any buildings here, which means... Yes, indeed. I'd say this is most likely on the north side, across the castle moat, and it should be southeast of this stable. Southeast of this stable? Okay. Oh, so we're like close by then. However, the area around the castle is extremely dangerous. If you find yourself in trouble, please promise to run fast. Okay, southeast of this stable. I guess we are like right by the castle then, huh? So is it like up on this hill? Is it literally where we just were? By that shrine? Or maybe it's like more over this way? I'm not too sure, but I guess we want to go... We want to head there. I'll put like... I guess like right around here is probably... Well, if we aim for here, then we're going to pass over this hill. We're going to get to this hill. Let's do it. Let's do that. Why not? Hi, doggy. I know. I gave you a bunch of meat. And also, let's grab horse. I don't know why I'm about to go by myself when we're at a stable and we can call horse over here. Look at it. I forgot we gave him the red mane. Oh my god. I love you, horse. You're my one companion from the start of the game. I love you. Hello. Actually, let's check inside real quick. Oh, you guys have got something going on. Hello. My theory is that the Leviathans of ancient times went extinct due to a sudden cataclysmic drought long ago. My theory is that the Leviathans of ancient times went extinct due to a violent volcanic eruption. My theory is that they went extinct due to an extended ice age. Oh, pardon me, I've gotten ahead of myself. Why did the Leviathans? Why did the Leviathans go extinct? That is the question we scientists are trying to answer. However, we haven't yet located any Leviathan remains, so we're stuck with theories for the time being. But we do have a general idea of where such remains might be found. The Eldon Mountains in the northeast of the Heber region, in the northeast, the Heber region in the northwest, and the Gerudo region in the southwest. The climates of these regions are rather extreme. You've got the look of someone who's done a fair bit of adventuring. Would you be willing to find these Leviathan bones and draw a picture of them? What I especially want to see is the head of the animal. If you can just get a bit of it in the picture, that'd be... if you can get just a bit of it in the picture, that is what he said. Okay, that'd be adequate. Do this for me, I'll give you 300 rupees as a reward. Leave it to me. Excellent! You're a lifesaver in the most literal sense. I'll be waiting here with your 300 rupees. Yeah, we're not doing that yet, I just wanted to actually activate the side quest. Also, look at this dude. Look at this this dude's face. Just staring at us. Anyway. Wow, I never thought I'd see you here. You must really enjoy my company. What are you looking for? Are you selling? I'm buying, Beetle. I am buying. I just made 300 bucks outside. I'm doing that. I'm buying. I'm gonna buy all of your little dragonfly things you've got. Temperatures to resist the cold. Sunset firefly that allows us to move more quietly. We'll gladly take those. Got money to burn right now, my guy. Well, I don't need those tireless frogs. You can hold on to the tireless frogs. I will take your arrows, though, because I'm burning through those as well. And these ones. I'll take all of them, buddy. Thank you, thank you. Alright. Thank you for business. You need anything else? Nope. All good. I will, however... Here we go. I'm gonna talk to Sprin over here. Who I just realized is also the same person who was on the outside. We're gonna do the soft bed. We'll sleep until nighttime. See what happens. Because obviously we're gonna get our hearts, we're gonna get some extra hearts. But also, if we sleep till night, I think we'll see Dinral? I didn't pay attention to what time it was before, but... I think Dinral appears at nighttime. Maybe it's morning. I honestly don't remember, but we're gonna go find out. If I'm even in the right place. Oh yeah, 100% we're in the right place. Dinral? Dinral? Maybe it's morning. I'm thinking it might be morning, actually. There he is, up in the sky. Right after midnight, it seems, is when he just spawned up there, and there's our guy. That's Dinral coming on down. Look at him! Oh my god, that's great, that's great. I'm glad that we've found him, because I've been wanting to do that shrine quest over at that other goddess statue that we saw forever ago, so getting Dinral's scale is gonna do that for us. Now the only thing... I guess we do have that shrine we could teleport back to, because once we go get this scale off of him, once we shoot him, it's gonna fall down. It's gonna go all the way down there. And, you are taking your sweet time, buddy. You are taking your sweet time getting down here. There's gotta be a better place to like, sleep and wait for him to- hello. I guess we'll fight you guys while we wait. Yeah, there's gotta be a better place to camp and wait for him to show up. Because, I'm pretty certain that all three of these dragons, they have, like, places you can just kind of spawn camp them. To grind their scales. There goes our cobble crusher, of course. Forest Dweller Sword. Get rid of that guy. Alright, here he comes. Here he comes. We just gotta wait for the wind to kick up so that we can actually jump up there. Let's keep following along. There it is. Fly on up there, Link. Okay. He's gonna start shooting out some fireballs, but we should be fine. As long as we're close enough, we got a good bit of his body to hit here, and... Did that work? That got him! Pay attention to where it falls. All the way down there. Okay, I thought it was gonna go a bit further than that, but thank you, Dinral, that's all I needed. That is all I needed from you. Oh, that's a bokoblin on a horse. And... Dinral's scale. This precious scale fell from the red spirit, Dinral. It emanates a great heat. You can use it in cooking, but just eating it seems like a waste. It sure does. We have another use for that. Alright, let's take these guys down. Why not? I feel like it. I feel like being mean to some bokoblins. Oh, that might not have been the best way to do it. I'm sorry, horse. I'm not trying to hit you. Also, you know what I did? You know what my stupid little brain did? I left horse at the stable. I left our horse at the stable. I called him over, got him ready to go, and then just left him at the stable. For some reason. Not quite sure why. Hi, buddy. Could you die? There we go. Take all of your parts. Is that a wolf? Why do wolves always try to fight us? I mean, they're not doing right now, but I feel like they're about to. You picking a fight? No, not dealing with you right now. Give me that raw prime meat. I wasted a bunch of raw prime meat on that one dog who didn't appreciate it. So I'll take that back off of you. And I'll take this horse, I guess. This is actually better than our horse, but this one's also down in a chasm, so we're probably not gonna get it back up. Yeah, I don't see a way to get this horse back up there. I just want to see what's over here, because this looks like some cool ruins. Sorry, new horse, didn't mean to do that. This looks like some cool ruins, and I don't know what the heck they are, and I'm curious. I would like to get that memory before the end of the episode, don't get me wrong, we're gonna do that. I'm just a little curious, what is going on over here? We got something up there, got some keys. Goodbye, forest dweller sword is badly damaged. The horse, what are you doing? Get over that rock, okay. What is this place? This is cool. I mean, I'm kind of hoping that a little location tag pops up at the bottom so that we can actually tell what this place is, but look at this! I guess it's just like, maybe there was a bridge higher up and it like fell down? The Forgotten Temple. Okay. Cool. This has got to be a Korok. Yeah! Hi, buddy. I did in fact find you. But what else is going on here? Because the horse is not getting through here. 100% that horse is not getting through here. Maybe we're not seeing the memory today. Maybe we're just climbing up this thing. Because we're already here. ADHD brain saw a new cool looking thing and I was like, well, I'm focused on this now. Anything back this side? No? Alright, Link, let's get climbing. Could we put on the climber's bandana? I mean, technically yes, but I'm not going to. Hello, dead guardian. You got nothing for me? Okay. This is neat. This is a temple? Oh, can we even... Oh, I think we might have reached an impasse. Can we go any further? Maybe this way? Because it's kind of like overhanging. I'm not sure if we can even get up there. Well, I guess if we climb around that bit, you know what? We will put on the climber's bandana. Majora's Mask is cool and all. But, we need to climb. We need better climbing. I just wish that we had something that wasn't a bandana, because I'm sick of seeing Link in this. I want to wear, like, some different clothes to help with climbing. Can we stand here? Oh. We could totally just stand on that little lip. Okay. Up you get, but whoa! Is it raining? Oh my god, of course it's raining. Right as we're almost at the top, it starts raining. We're not allowed to climb in this game. You know, this game does not like us doing that. I could pay attention to the weather forecast at the bottom, but I never do. Link? Okay, he was stuck. He couldn't figure out how to do that part. Okay, let's just walk over here. Yeah, we're not making it any further up. Oh, this looks cool though. I do like this. I do like this. I don't know why I'm bothering climbing up here. Whoa! We're fine. That horse that we left down there might not be, but we're fine. Oh, I guess because this is under the little lip part, it doesn't get affected by the rain. So maybe we can make it up there. Maybe we can. Yeah, I don't know why I'm bothering to climb it. We could just go back up to the stable and just kind of walk around this whole bit, but... Hey, we're almost there now, and sure enough, this lip does counteract the rain. Or, I guess, block the rain from hitting the part that we're climbing on, so this works. We might just make this- Okay! Not when we get to there. Jump! Oh, we're not gonna make it now. Oh yeah, 100% we're not making it. Okay. Good job, Link. You tried. Oh, you need to put that reinforced Lazal shield away. Good god. Oh yeah, catch your breath, buddy. Catch your breath. I'm out of breath from doing that. Of course it had to rain right as we want to climb. You know, that's just how these things go. But I guess that's probably gonna be it for this episode. We don't really have much else to do. I mean, we have other stuff that I want to go do, but we're probably just gonna save it all for next episode, because we got a good amount of, stuff in this episode. We got the idea of where the memory is, we got the Dinral scale, I got reminded of the Luminous Stones. I kind of want to go do that just so that I can stop forgetting. Also, of course it stops raining as I stop climbing. Hold on. So, I don't know how I didn't notice this part, and also the rain just started up again. I made it over here in just enough time. But in here, there is just a giant open section that I didn't notice before. I was trying to climb over this thing, and there's... Oh my god. Oh, I know what this is! Hold on! I've just remembered. There's guardians! There's a lot of guardians! Okay, we gotta glide. We gotta just fly through here. Drop down! Oh god, this is terrifying. Come on, catch that updraft, Link. There you go. Oh my god! We gotta just get in there. You are... Oh my god. Is there a shrine in here? That would make sense. Get in there, Link. Oh, there's more. There's so many more guardians. I forgot that there were guardians here, I'm not gonna lie. I know I said I remember this, I just remembered what was... Like, what this area was. Not that it was full of guardians. Oh god. There's probably a chest hidden in here somewhere that we've not seen. But at the moment, I don't think we really have the time to be worrying about that. And there it is, the shrine. Okay, I knew this was gonna be something, and there's a giant goddess statue in the back. Just, okay, I guess we got what we're gonna start the next episode with, folks. Shrine, goddess statue. I know I was gonna go back to Kakariko after getting 16 spirit orbs, but there's one right here, so we can at least get a few upgrades. But that is gonna be next time. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.